you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken of her by the Lord.
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever.
For a child was Before we do Bethlehemian Rhapsody, I would just like us to pray so that we can dedicate the puppet stage and the performers and all the help that we got to make this possible.
Holy God, as you know, this whole process became with a request from Ashley. Everyone in this congregation knows how much of a Queen fan she is. And so when she saw the song Bethlehemian Rhapsody on YouTube, she asked if we could do it. And so this request has just blossomed with your guidance, Lord God. And you brought to us some wonderful puppeteers full of experience from Church of Nazarene. And we give you thanks for them. You gave us Dale Spitzeri working on his Eagle Scout project from our Boy Scout Troop 141. And he took the request to make this stage to a whole new level. His mom put in countless hours making the curtains. His dad at the troop making the stage. And together, Lord God, with our new puppeteers here at Heidelberg, I'm just so proud of everyone and so thankful that we want to dedicate this stage and this new ministry that has been born as we prepare for the birth of Jesus Christ to your glory. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Is this the real birth?
second way that we engage in worship. The way that we normally engage in worship in this congregation is we come to church knowing that we're sinners and we begin with a confession. The other way that we worship is to recognize that the scriptures and the message convict us, and so the confession comes after the message. So that is the order that we're doing worship this morning. We do not think that God might be angry with us, yet we know the emptiness of our prayers, the greed of our consumption, the limits of our compassion. God understands more profoundly than we our failure to become the people we are intended to be. In silent reflection, be open to the wisdom and forgiveness of the Creator as we take a moment of silent personal reflection.
And let us pray together.